In today's video, we're gonna look at some of the new Microsoft accessibility features in relation to how they're going to export to accessible PDFs. Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. My name is Sean Jordison, and let's jump right in. This video was inspired by a post from Jenny Lay Fleury, who is the Chief Accessibility Officer at Microsoft. On a LinkedIn post, she posted an update that the new Outlook has some new inclusive features, like an immersive reader, dictation, Zoom, themes, and an accessibility checker. There can be automatic reading of mail messages, and there's gonna be some additional updates. And way down in here at the bottom, we have exporting Office 365 documents to PDF. The team has made over 100 improvements to make exporting your Excel charts, Word documents, and PowerPoint slide decks to PDF more accessible. Once ready, hit the accessibility checker in Office, then save export as PDF, and it now includes tags for shapes with alt text, and equations, improvements to tables, headers, and hyperlinks, and word art preserved as text. Let's open up a brand new document. Let's test out some word art. It has always sort of been in accessibility like that you can't really use word art, because what would happen is a lot of the text would just come through as a figure tag, and there wouldn't be anything you can really do about the objects on the page itself. And this would create a lot of issues. So let's try this smart art option there. It says improvements to tables and hyperlinks. Let's apply a style to this table. We're just doing some random data in here. We're gonna do a header. All right, so we've got a dummy table in there. It said something about equations too. Let's do insert equation, and we're just gonna choose like a random equation. I'm very curious to see how this comes through, because it almost always comes through incorrectly whenever you are taking it to PDF. Math equations specifically built into Word have always had a lot of trouble, and they've always thrown false positives. So if you had like an equation with MathML, which is technically considered accessible, it would still require you to put in alternate text. And so I'm wondering if it's gonna do the same thing here. We're gonna say Microsoft Equation Editor. And then I have math type, which allows me to also insert this as math type. So let's try that. Or MathML, I should say. So we're gonna go with the MathPix snipping tool instead. I'm going to launch the snipping tool, do a new snip, and I'm just gonna take my quadratic equation there, and we want to take our LaTeX here, or let's take the MathML. We're gonna copy that for Microsoft Word and paste it in. And hopefully that worked. All right, so we should be able to test two different things. And then what was the other thing? All right, if we deep dive a little further, there's some more information on the features from the Microsoft webpage. Recent improvements to PDF accessibility, exporting accessible PDF on iOS and Mac. This feature is also available to PowerPoint. That's pretty big. Mac has always had some trouble in exporting to a formatted PDF. Bookmarks for sections and slides in PowerPoint and headings, or bookmarks in Word. That's cool, it added some improvements for bookmarks. Over 100 improvements to PDF UA tags, the most suitable tags for shapes with text, alt text, and equations. Formula tags with alt text for equations in Excel and PowerPoint. Figure with alt text for every other type of graphical object. We've got flat figure, no nesting smart arts for groups in PowerPoint. Hyperlinks aren't nested in figure tag anymore in PowerPoint. Artifact and no tags for decorative objects on Slide Master. Removed unnecessary span and p tags. Merged table cells have row span and column span in PowerPoint. Wow, that's a big one for PowerPoint. Lists have proper nesting of the LBL. Footnotes and endnotes contain links. Block quotes for Word paragraph quote and intense quote styles. Quote for Word quote styles. Title for Word title style. That's pretty cool. All right, so it appears a lot of this is coming straight from PowerPoint, but let's put in a title. That has always come through as a P tag. So now that it's gonna come through as a title tag, that'll be kind of interesting. Let's go ahead and follow the steps. We're gonna do file, info, check accessibility, and we've got something missing alt text. So this is my shapes. We're just gonna do sample one and see what comes up there. All right, now we can click. So we want the save or export. So let's do export. We're gonna do file, export, create PDF XPS, create PDF XPS. We can check our options in here. We've got document, create bookmarks using headings, document properties, document structure tags for accessibility. All right, perfect. Let's publish it. Open up our file, select tags. Interesting. So that title tag actually came through as an H1. That's powerful. All right, that's something. All right, we've got, nice, a T-head tag. This has never been a T-head tag. Oh, we still got paths coming through. This is because the shading on my table. So that's annoying that that's still an issue, but the table headers seem to be coming through okay. Well, let's check this figure tag. So this still didn't work very well. It claimed that the smart art was gonna be preserved, but maybe this is still a bug in Word. All our text is coming through as paths. So that's not very good. Let's check out our equations. All right, interesting. I've never seen math appear like that, but it does have a path object in there. And it's showing up for both of mine. So there's still gonna be some work for what needs to happen with our math content. I would say the biggest takeaway that I can see is that the title tag is now coming through as an H1. The smart art objects are still not coming through very appropriately. Perhaps this is better solved in PowerPoint. We're gonna test that in another video. And the math equations, it does seem to display the math appropriately in the tags panel, which is something I am not used to seeing. Normally it comes through as like a stacked whole bunch of text. So maybe they're making some improvements here for math to be inlaid properly to a PDF with accessibility in mind. So that's pretty exciting. If you want to deep dive into some of these document remediation techniques, you can find out more information about the Accessibility Guide community, where we have a whole bunch of self-paced courses via a link below this video. And if you want to find out how I can help you get accessible, there's a link for that too. As always, I could be your champion for inclusion. Thank you so much for joining me today, and I'll see you next time.